Hello, good afternoon all. Since we are on this theme of limitless, I'd like to narrate this thing. Once upon a time, there was a great king. His name was Janaka. He had everything going for him, but still there was some void. He was miserable and he kept seeking answers. So in search for those answers, he found one answer which really liberated him. This answer was given by a 12-year-old physically deformed boy. The essence of it is contained in the Ashtavakra Gita, and it says, and he says in essence, that O king, you're miserable or you're unhappy or whatever you want to call it, it's because you've not been able to, you know, open your eyes to the infinity within you. Very profound. But is it, how do we access it? How do we get to see the limitlessness inside each of us? Is it as simple as what Bradley Cooper would have us believe in the movie by the same title, Limitless, that is by popping a pill? Well, I think each of us discovers ourselves, that is if we do, through our own journeys. My journey in the bureaucracy has been as enriching as it has been challenging. I've been in the Indian Administrative Service for 10 years now, which includes the time I had taken off for having my kids. I was first introduced to government, having no background of anybody from the government, as a probationer in Dakshin Kannada. I've seen how this proverbial elephant moves. And then I was posted as assistant commissioner and shortly given the charge, additional charge of this municipal corporation of Tumkur. Being a greenhorn, there was a lot of things. I was a rookie, learning a lot of things. One of the things I did learn was to have a sense of humor on the job, because here I was as this municipal commissioner feeling all responsible for 3 lakh people, thinking of great things I need to do. One fine day I just got this call, 3 days or 4 days into the job. It was around 6 or 6:30 in the morning. I got a call saying, hello, is this the municipality? I said, yes. He said, see, there is this dead animal in front of my house. Can you get it cleaned? So I was like, yeah, basics, okay. That apart, there's the other learnings, like government works on a scale which is huge. It is not like an NGO or, you know, it's not about helping few people. The scales are huge. One, that was a huge learning. The second was that there are many stakeholders with many interests, and navigating the system and getting things done is a very difficult job. But the most important learning of everything was at that time that your own personality could be a limitation. Sometimes you just don't measure up to the job. So there is a lot of learning and unlearning one has to do. It's not that you've cleared a tough examination and you've arrived. It doesn't work like that. There's really a lot of learning and unlearning one has to do. Apart from this, I also learned that a lot of our time gets eaten up in routine. Like doing routine administration takes up all our time. We feel that we are actually, because we are pulled in all directions, we feel we have gone places, but we're actually in the same, very same place where we began. So one of my fundamental learnings was, with the routine, it's important to have some programs to be able to execute them in a time-bound manner. So as Tumkur Municipal Commissioner, one of my first things we took up was widening and asphalting of roads. So MG Road, if any of you is from Tumkur would know, is one of the busiest roads in Tumkur. And in a record 9-month time, we could clear the encroachments, make it wide and asphalt it. And when the road was getting inaugurated, it was my first project which we actually saw till completion. There were other roads we did take up, like the JC Road or Pet Road and all, but we couldn't complete it in time. Secondly, the second important project we did take up there was this landfill site. We know solid waste management is a huge issue. It's an issue even in Bangalore, even today. At that point of time, Tumkur collects around 100 metric tons of waste every day, and there was no place where we could process it, the dry waste. And the municipality had taken 40 acres of land 10 years back, but then because of resistance from the locals and the neighboring villages, we just couldn't take possession of it. So engaging the citizens and negotiations is one thing I'd learned at this point of time, because there were protracted negotiations with all the stakeholders involved. And there was this very powerful politician. He said, see, I understand all you're trying to say. I know your municipality needs this and all, but I just can't be seen with you. I have to be seen on the other side. So I'm going to protest, or I'm going to pretend that I'm protesting. So help me. No, it really happened. And then on the day when we went to take possession, so there were 1,000 of them on the other side, all the villagers and whoever were the important stakeholders and who didn't have a stake or who just came to see. And on this side, we were around 200 policemen, because we apprehended a law and order issue could arise. So since morning, they were giving speeches and telling municipality down and all these things. We gave them breakfast, we gave them lunch. Slowly, the crowd filtered away and the issue resolved. And to date, till date, I mean, they're using it. We could take possession of it. How do you take possession of land? By fencing it. So we could fence it, and it's being used to segregate and process the dry waste till date. So that was one other thing in Tumkur. So the learning from Tumkur were citizen participation, because it was majorly a urban setup. And there were a lot of unlearnings too, how a lot of things should not be done. And the best part of our job, which I love the most, is the diversity which we get to experience. So from this urban setting, I was then posted as Zilla Panchayat CEO in Mandya, a rural setup. The contrast was that in the urban setting, you need things to happen at a fast pace. But in a rural setting, there is a certain amount of time lag you can experience. So in Mandya, again, I didn't want to get drowned in routine. So what we prioritized 3 programs and thought that if we can focus on this, we would be able to come up with some results. So one of them was the Swachh Bharat mission. I really tried to test scale, you know, the scale of the government, as I said earlier, in the Swachh Bharat mission. And then there was this infant mortality rate. We wanted to bring it down. It's very difficult. In a place like Mandya, which falls in southern Karnataka, the IMR at that time was 34 infant deaths per month. That's almost an average of 1 child per day. And the third was integrated farming practices. Mandya is primarily a sugarcane growing district, and sugarcane is known as a lazy man's crop. So we wanted to get horticulture, animal husbandry, sericulture, and all, you know, to train farmers to look at diversifying their crop and getting more income. Because sugarcane is not seen to be viable at that time, and a lot of farmers were committing suicide. So of the three, the first one, which I tried to test scale on, based on different surveys, we realized that there were 1,20,000, 1,30,000 odd toilets which needed to be constructed in Mandya. So we said, okay, let's build 1 lakh toilets in this year. That was like constructing 270 toilets in a single day. So this required massive mobilization of material, men, labor, and motivation. You can be motivated for a day, for a week, maybe for a month, but to be motivated for a year, it took a lot of effort. I had toured almost all the 232 gram panchayats in Mandya, had innumerable meetings with the gram panchayat adhyakshas, PDOs, watermen, bill collectors. And there's one thing I did realize, that there is no role clarity at the cutting edge, at the last level in government. You get this clarity when there are missions, like there's an election or there's a survey. Some such times there's some role clarity. But generally, because this has been the machinery and you've been loading it with a lot of schemes and other things, there really is no role clarity. But by taking up one activity, I realized that the whole organization really got enlivened up to the fact, and then we could deliver other schemes also very well. So we did achieve 1 lakh toilets in 1 year. It's just not about physical construction of things, because that can be easily done, but it's about the behavioral change, which takes time. But we had initiated a program, a process of IEC and talking to them, so something was happening. But sadly, just 1 year into the job, I was transferred. I had gone and requested that, please give me just 3 more months, I'll finish. There's this concept of open defecation free district, which most of the districts are now. And I went and requested, because I didn't see any apparent reason why I was transferred. So I went and requested, but it wasn't accepted. I took it in my stride and just went on. The next posting was as DC in Hassan. On getting posted there, I realized that we just had 5 months to conduct a mega event, which was the Mastakabhisheka, wherein 25 lakh pilgrims were expected to come. It was called the Jain Kumbh, happens once in 12 years. There was no institutional memory of what they did in the last 12 years also, because 12 years is a lot of time to maintain all the records. And we had two challenges. One was, because it was a religious congregation and it was a Jain festival, so to say, and Jains are very, very particular on their eating habits and many other habits. We had some 500-600 munis and matas staying with us for an extended period of time. The challenge was that they wouldn't drink water from a borewell which is dug, or a well, or piped water. So how do you give them water? And then they wouldn't use the toilets you have set up for them. They would want to do it in the open. So sanitation and water supply for the munis and matas actually became an issue. And we did make some arrangement for them for that open kind of toilet. And then we got a notice from the Safai Karmachari Commission saying that you are doing, you know, manual scavenging. So there was this tightrope between the religious feelings of a community and the law of the land. We did manage to somehow do it. We gave them water in a very innovative way. And then we replied to these notices also. But the more challenging aspect was scaffolding. You're all aware that the Bahubali statue is 57 feet high and it is located on a hill, which is 450 feet. And the last Mastakabhisheka, they took 6 months to put up the scaffolding and we only had 5 months. And then I had this minister who was very particular that this work should be given to a particular agency whom we did not believe had the necessary expertise to carry it out. So I tried reasoning with him. I said, see, if there is a catastrophe, suppose the scaffolding falls, not only there is a loss to life, but also the idol which many Jains believe as a living god and who with so much reverence, some damage to them, to that idol, which is an archaeologically protected monument, is a national disaster. It's a national shame for Karnataka. But somehow he just didn't get it. And luckily for me, the chief minister then overruled him and we gave it to a good agency. We could overcome these two challenges and the event went off hassle-free and the user experience has been very good. They said good things about the Mastakabhisheka. But in governance, we face these kind of issues, these kind of challenges on a day-to-day basis. Shortly after the event, I was transferred. And this time I knew why I was transferred also, but I couldn't take it in my stride because I didn't understand for doing honest, good work, you shouldn't be transferred in 7 months. So I challenged it and I came back to the same place. And this time with many other programs, we had focus on education, especially the 10th standard results. 10th standard we know is very important in all our lives, the 10th standard marks especially. When I joined Hassan in 2017, July, I realized that the last academic year's performance, Hassan ranked at 31st place. There are 32 educational districts in Karnataka and we were at ranked 31. So it's a very bad state of affairs. We focused on education with the education department. We had, and there was a change in syllabus also. The syllabus were upgraded to the NCRT. So we had a lot of workshop for the teachers. I had radio programs. I had written personally to each of the principals and teachers. We had mothers' workshops for students who weren't performing well. So all these steps led Hassan to be ranked at 7 in 2018. And in the history of Hassan, it got ranked first in 2019. In both the qualitative and the quantitative parameters. It's not just the number of people passing and even looking at the pass percentage, but also the number of people who got good marks. So in both these parameters, it ranked first. So it was a hugely satisfying experience. And then subsequently after that, I'm right now in the labor department, which again is a challenging job. But what I have realized that there are many challenges in the job we do. There is political interference. You don't get security of tenure. You don't get time enough to do something. But then at the same time, there are these opportunities. There are these amazing seniors we have who have worked in far more challenging circumstances and produced far more better results. They act as our mentors, they guide us. And to sum it up, in the context of Limitless, we all know, it is often said that in this life, there are many ways to lead our life. The number of ways we can lead our life is limitless. And I truly believe that the service gives us that opportunity to lead life in a limitless number of ways. There are many challenges, the external challenges notwithstanding. I believe that we have to overcome our own limitations. And we need to do that by constant endeavor. As Gautam Buddha has said, by striving diligently. And by doing the right action, which is the right karma, in the Mahabharatas of our life, to truly get limitless. Thank you.